Do you know there's a real Citibank, not this Hollywood prop?
Yeah, they haven't finished that.
What the hell? I've been like...
Yeah, it's not finished yet.
I see that.
No.
Okay.
Citibank?
I mean, Chase.
Oh, Chase.
I don't know why I said Citibank.
There's a Chase up across from the other Starbucks, as a matter of fact.
Where's that?
Just past Corbin.
I'm not from the area. How far down?
One major light, like
right.
Off ramp.
On the right
then,
or the left?
And then half of the... it will be on your right.
Thank you. Have a blessed day.
You too.
I am. Thank you. Okay. Now I know where the other bank is. How thrilling. 39 new messages. I'm so excited. Wow, you're beautiful. What do you do? Aside from showing people. This will get you sued for millions. You better pull it down right the fuck now. Thank you. Furthermore, it's slanderous, it's libelous, and if you don't take it down, I will sue you and Facebook for fucking millions. I'm not joking. You're now over the fucking line, you lunatic. This is your third and final fucking warning. If you continue to do this, you will face a federal judge, you will face a prison sentence, because you are intentionally causing me great harm, stress, duress, slander, libel, theft, and you're fucking with me. And I'm done with this horseshit. Grow up, little girl. Go get help. Seriously, before you get arrested.
please.
Get into a 12-step program, rehab, a doctor, whatever it is you need, and get the help you need, and then contact me. But seriously, you are risking serious lawsuit if you continue this harassment and abuse. As if you already don't have enough delusional troubles. Impersonation of a federal official and lying about it like you did is a federal offense. So you might want to rethink your position, because I have you on tape stating it. Thank you.
No, I can't.
How long have you been here? Oh, I got here about a half hour ago. I've been walking around. Yep. Being harassed and tormented by my Avengers. God. Hi.
How's it going? What are you doing with the wrist bands?
They're the mental institutions I should go back to. There are events that I've been at recently, like last night I was VIP backstage all access with members of Quiet Riot and Guns N' Roses and tons of bands. They were doing a tribute to Prince at the Whiskey. And this was the virtual reality event. And this one I like so much because of the way it is. I just haven't bothered to take it off. And I've just been at a lot of events, obviously, covering NAB and doing shows lately, so I'm exhausted. Between that and the psychodrama I've been going through with these people, it's exhausting. And I just slowed down enough today after I talked to you to take a look and find out I probably broke my foot. I have a huge big bruise on the top of my foot, either from when she stomped on me getting out of the car beating me, or when that guy hit me walking around on the set on Sunday in the fucking dark. And And I smashed my foot really bad. So I don't know where the actual break took place, but I think I broke my foot. I should probably go to a hospital and get it checked. Of course, I was not supposed to be in a hospital 8 weeks ago getting this lump checked on my throat for possible cancer, but there's just been so much psychodrama going on trying to... I've had 5 break-ins in the last 2 months. No, 6. I don't know. I'd love to. I would love coffee and water. Yeah, thank you. So dehydrated. And I ran across the street to the Hollywood prop across the street that I thought was a Chase Bank. But it's not. They're just building one. It's not open yet. So it looks like a giant Hollywood set. I went, So I'm exhausted, dude.
Yeah.
Oh, I feel beat to shit. I feel like I've gone through the Central American War again, except it hasn't stopped. When I was inadvertently drop-shipped into, you know, the war in Central America as a gift. Well, that was fun. I've had some pretty strange gifts in my lifetime. Here, have an all-expense-paid trip for two weeks, a barefoot cruise through the West French Indies and through Panama and Central America, and you'll be stopping all through Central America.
You don't have to go.
I didn't. I was 19. They didn't tell me that there was a possible war going on in Central America and that they were drop shipping me onto a boat with the CIA. I didn't find that out until I got there.
You didn't tell me you were 19.
I was 19.
This just happened.
Oh, no. This didn't just happen. This was 19. That's why I said I've had strange gifts in my life. The network gave me this gift, and it turned out to be a fact-finding mission. They just didn't bother to tell me before I left. Oh my God, I thought that said assholes. It's a second. I was like, yay, I need one of these cups. My cousin sent me, I love this phone, where is it? A thing that I think is so appropriate for me, and I think you might find humor in it. And so I saved it on the screen, I think. So when I lit up the phone, I could show you. Oh shit, it went off screen. Oh, there you go. My cousin sent me that. So I just reposted it on Facebook because that is me. I would say something like that. Abso-frickin-lutely. The Prince show that I went to last night was life-changing. I was on the verge of just throwing in the towel and saying, fuck this, I can't do this ever again. Because I'm so tired of being beaten. I've been beaten head to toe since I've last seen you. I've fractures head to toe. I've had assaults. People shoot at me. It's been a challenge being me lately. So, in my next life, I've already decided I'm not coming back to be Jesus Christ again and try and save the fucking planet from this dumbass. I'll just let them do whatever they want. And I'll just keep the mic on in the world and stay off the main stage for a while.
That would be a great idea.
Because Bill's like, what's wrong with you? Why do you still, you bring a homeless person to your house and you leave them for a week? Are you shocked that they stole 4 computers? Are you surprised you have anything left in your house? What are you thinking? I've told you to stop doing it. And you've done it before. And it's happened before, so why do you keep doing it?
You're sick and tired of getting what you're getting. Quit doing what you're doing.
Because I'm trying to help people.
Listen, you can't help yourself. Quit trying to help everybody else. When you start learning how to help yourself, then you can start helping
yourself. I usually am pretty good at helping myself.
And only
it's
then can you start.
Just when I have people like the gens of the world under my
head. Then and only then can you start helping others.
Okay, Dad.
Well, you need a good swift kick in the butt. You really
you have to understand. It's in my DNA to help the hungry,
change
the homeless.
DNA.
It's tough. It's been a lot of years.
What would you like to eat?
What do you recommend? I've never been here before. I have no idea. What do you recommend?
On the house.
I would say fried chicken.
The who did who?
The fried chicken.
Recommends the fried chicken.
The fried. No, I don't do fried.
No. Okay. No.
What do you have non-fried?
Turkey dinner.
Okay.
A what?
Turkey dinner.
You want a turkey dinner?
Yeah, I don't want to sleep. The tryptophan will make me go like this.
Joe.
I'm being honest.
What would you like?
What do you? Here, I'll look at it.
Salad. I'll give you a few minutes.
Do you have chicken that's not fried? Do you have like broiled chicken?
You have grilled chicken.
Oh, okay. Grilled chicken.
You want to have just chicken breast, or you want to have salad?
Do you have asparagus or spinach or something?
We have spinach.
Spinach? How's it prepared?
You want to do a dinner? You can do sautéed spinach. You can do regular.
Yeah, that's fine.
Yeah.
Are you eating?
No, I just ate.
Well, then I can eat.
I
want to
have a piece of pie.
I can just have coffee. I can eat later.
I want to have a piece of pie.
Sautéed.
What's your best pie?
You should ask that question first, shouldn't I?
I do.
You do?
Ooh.